Bir kere yeryüzünde Hristiyanlar olması, Museviler olması Müslüman için büyük bir nimet olmayabilirlerdi. Onlar da
For
ateist
one
olmak
thing,
istemsiz
the
olabilirler.
fact that there are Christians and Muslims in the
Ama
world is a great
dediğim
blessing
doğru.
for
Eğer
Muslims,
iman nasip
for there
edilirse
need not have been any. They could have been atheists, irreligious people, but Allah bestowed the blessing of faith on them, and Christians feel a deep love for the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, and Jews for the Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. These faiths have been restored, of course, and the Quran has told the members of those faiths of the deficiencies stemming from these distortions. The gaps and deficiencies in Christianity and Judaism are revealed in the Quran. Therefore, Christians are our brothers, for they are of the old religion of Islam. We must treat them with love and affection. We must avoid any behavior that might exclude them. We must struggle shoulder to shoulder with them against Darwinism and atheism. Devout Christians love Muslims. The fact that they believe in Allah, await the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, love the Blessed Maryam and the other prophets, means they harbor a profound love for Muslims. So what needs to be done is for the devout people all over the world to embrace one another very tightly. There are two forces in the world. There are those who do not believe in Allah, and there are those who do believe in Him. There is a struggle between the friends and enemies of Allah. We will join with the friends of Allah.
Masonluk, bir tek Müslümanlara karşı tavır almış değil. Dindar Museviler İsrail'de inim inim iniyorlar. İnsanlar bu
Masonry doesn't have an attitude only against Muslims because religious Jews in Israel are also crying out bitterly. There are Jews in other parts of the world that I am in contact with and they cannot walk around wearing a kippah. They are insulted, defamed and beaten. They cannot travel around freely because there is infliction upon them in many parts of the world. Pious Christians are also in similar circumstances. For instance, a nun may walk around in some regions of Italy, but she cannot travel in many places without restraint. They either insult or offend her, or she is mocked. It's even harder to travel around in other parts of the world. Just consider a man in clerical clothing, he will face incredible suffering. This means there is an atheist Zionist plan to divide, oppress and do away with religious people. The atheist Zionists and Masons have a plan. This is the plan to eradicate all believers in Allah from over the earth, because Satan is not only against Islam, but also against all believers in Allah. This is the goal of Satan. Therefore, devout Christians and devout Muslims should unite against infidels, atheists and Masons. If we don't get united, we will confront with alliance of Masons. They're united against us just like atheist Zionists. However, believers are divided. In that case, their power could prevail over. Consider that all oppressed Muslims in various parts of the world come together along with devout Jews and devout Christians. Whose power would resist against that alliance? Then, we should be on the side of unity. It's very important that believers protect and watch over one another.
Hristiyanlığın Yahudilere bakışı İncil'deki anlatıma göre biraz iç açıcı değil tabi. Ama Kur'an'da Yahudi kavmi, Museviler şefkat duyulması gereken insanlar olarak belirtilir. Yahudilere genel anlamda Museviler diyeyim ben. Tabii ki şefkat duyulması lazım. Yani gerçek
approach of Christianity towards the Jews is not the pleasant as described in the Bible, but the Quran tells us we must feel affection for the Jewish people, for the Jews. We must feel love for the Jews in general. I mean, if someone is a genuine Jew and sincerely wants to live by his faith, he's one of the people of the book. And if one wishes, one can marry these people, marry their women. One can eat with them and have business relations and social relations with them and live in the same part of town. We can live as brothers. In that sense, love for the Jews is a religious obligation. This is very normal and useful, and itself an act of worship. But the real danger and the problem we face is that unbelieving Jews portray themselves as devout and seek to rule the world under the influence of Satan and with their links to Freemasonry. Otherwise, no harm comes to anyone from devout, sincere Jews who merely live according to their own religion. They seek to abide by the commands of the Torah, and Islam protects them.
Ehli kitabın hükmü Kur'an'da açıkça belirtilmiştir. Peygamberimizin fiili sünnetiyle de çok açıktır. Ehli kitap bizim kardeşlerimizdir, Ermeniler.
The commands regarding the people of the book is set out very clearly in the Quran. And the actions and sunnah of our Prophet sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem are also very clear. The people of the book are our brothers. Armenians, Jews, the Orthodox, Protestants, the Christian world, in other words, are all our brothers. We believe in the same Allah. Allah is the same Allah in the Judaic world, the Christian world, and Islam. They all have the same basic beliefs, for which reason the existence of the people of the book is a blessing. In other words, it's a great blessing that they are not irreligious or part of some other heretical movement, but are actually the people of the book. There is nothing to alarm Muslims in this, it's perfectly reasonable. Because Allah says in the Quran that the people of the book exist. They will do good things and Muslims will do good things. They are people one can live with as brothers, talk with, eat and drink with. And one can even marry Christian or Jewish girls and live an entirely normal social life with them. They are also trustworthy. If a woman becomes someone's wife, if he has children by that woman, and if they live together in the same family, that means a very powerful friendship and love. The standpoint of Islam is not merely the well-being of Muslims, but also on that of the people of the book and of the associators, because they will also be protected. They also need to be protected. Allah informs in a verse, "I seek refuge with Allah from Satan." They convey them to a place where they are safe. Allah commands us to accompany and protect them. This verse is for associators. So Allah instructs us to safeguard them, even if they are pagans. Muslims are under obligation to protect their lives. Therefore, laicism is imperative for having each one of them as first-class citizens. This is not open to discussion. It's a requisite in Islam.
The Armenians are the people of the book. They love the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him. They love Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, and all the prophets, peace be upon them all. They love and respect Allah. They believe in the hereafter, so why have we been separated from them? We will open the border up, inshallah. They will be able to establish the links they desire with Turkey. We will open schools and facilities in Armenia, and they will come and work here. We will clear the way for Azerbaijan. Armenians, Azeris and Turks will live side by side, at ease and as brothers. They will restore the Azeri territory that was occupied, inshallah. They will give those lands back to Azerbaijan. And we will put an end to this strife, inshallah. Armenians also believe in Allah. They believe in all the prophets. They believe in Jesus and Moses and Abraham, peace be upon them all, and the hereafter, so what more can one ask? What could be better? They are the people of the book, and they are innocent, people of art who are devoted to Allah. They labor with that mentality. That's how they were all in Ottoman times. The Armenians were all artists, scientists, and doctors. But then a corruption brought up by Darwinists smothered everything. The corruption of racism, the mindset of the comedy of union and progress. They've been filled with hatred for the nation for a century now. But the corruption of Darwinism has been eliminated, and we have buried Darwinism itself, thanks be to Allah. At present, the world is clear from such fallacies, so from now on, the age of brotherhood will get started, inshallah. One of the common tenets between Muslims and the people of the book before all else is faith in Allah. There is agreement and belief in heaven and hell, and there is agreement and belief in angels and in all prophets. They have faith in all the prophets other than the Prophet Muhammad, may Allah bless him and grant him peace. We also accept all of them, believe all, and have faith in all. They also have the lawful and unlawful, and most of them are the same. The only difference is that pork and wine are acceptable in Christianity, while pork is unlawful in Judaism, and wine is considered to be hideous. For example, there is circumcision in Judaism as well,
And there are many aspects, descriptions and explanations in the Torah which conform with the Prophet's, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, guidance, such as clothing and manners. These are important in terms of uniformity, but the only problem with Christianity is their doctrine of Trinity. Their faith breaks up Allah into three: Allah, the Holy Spirit, and the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him. This is totally wrong, and Allah warns about this in the Quran and informs us that there is only one God. Because the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, is Allah's servant who eats, sleeps, and prays. We see this in the Bible as well as the Quran. He continually prays to Allah in the Bible. Would Allah pray to Allah? He gets hungry, thirsty, he needs to sleep, and he does so. Would Allah sleep? Could there be an instant when Allah sleeps?
Musevi dini de eski bir İslam dinidir. Ama tabi İslam gelince asıl din İslam olmuştur. O hükmü kalkmış oluyor. Yani İslam esas olmuş olur.
Judaism is also an old form of Islam religion. But with Islam's revelation, the actual religion has become Islam and the other one is abolished. Islam, the religion brought by our Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, is the principal faith. But their compliance to their own law is also acceptable in the Quran, since Allah says the people of the book exist. We call them to Islam, but even if they do not become Muslim, they're still the people of the book, because they're loyal to the law of the Prophet Moses, peace be upon him. Christianity is loyal to the law of the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, and survives as a community devoted to him. We call them the people of the book.
Muslims can marry them, take their daughters as wives.
One eats their food, meat they have prepared. You can eat what Jews have prepared. You can go to their homes and eat with them. One can be their guests and talk with them. You can stay over in their homes and they can stay over with you. What does that mean? This is a bond of close friendship and brotherhood.
Ama mesela tek Allah'a inanmaları, namaz kılmaları var, mesela oruç tutmaları var, namusa dikkat ediyorlar, helale harama dikkat ediyorlar. Yani
for instance, they have faith in Allah only. They pray and fast, they are meticulous about modesty and observant of the lawful and unlawful. Both Christianity and Judaism are intertwined with Islam. They have various disordered aspects and without these, they would be a religion of Islam as well. They will comply with the Quran and follow the Quran, but not yet. When the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, comes, Jews and Christians will totally abide by the Quran, inshallah. The circumcision of children is a religious service carried out for thousands of years among Jews. This is the same in Islam. All children are born uncircumcised and then they are circumcised.
Bunlar hep düzeltilebilecek şeyler. Çünkü ana kaideler ve ana inanç konuları durduktan sonra onlar bir şekilde düzeltilebilir inşallah.
These are all correctable things because one's main tenets and principles of faith are sustained. Others can somehow be rectified. Yet, that will become more explicit and evident with the appearance of the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, and Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him. And all will be completely put in order. Armenians are a separate nation from us. Their religion is also different. Allah has created them that way. For instance, Allah informs there will be differences in religion as well. Allah informs us in the Quran that there is not only one religion, but also Christians and Jews. Even Sabians and pagans are mentioned in the Quran as well as many other human types and peoples. These have already been explained in the Quran, and Allah notifies us of the laws we have towards them. Allah tells us to have compassion for them and even safeguard the pagans when they go from one place to another. There's a verse about this. Even though these people are idolaters, Allah holds us liable of their safety until they arrive in security. Take into account the time of the Prophet, peace be upon him, when there was war, and despite this, Allah commands to protect them. There are different religions. This is normal since Allah created them. But we will have understanding, compassion, and kindness for them all. We will be caring and protecting. Surely there will be unity among Muslims in Turkish Islamic Union, because this is a command of Allah, and we will have ties of brotherhood. As Allah says in the verse that we created us as nations, and no Muslim is able to object to this. He will say Allah created us as nations, and he will act as required. There is no place for discussion here. Israel is of the lineage of the prophets, of the lineage of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, peace be upon them all. They are a holy people, the Jews, very intelligent and very well-mannered. They are very careful over what is lawful and unlawful. They fear Allah, they love Allah and believe in His oneness. They are fastidious in their worship, and it is their right to be happy. These are people who have preserved the traces of Ottoman upbringing, who have maintained it in their families. And these people, the people of the book, believe in the oneness of Allah. They fear and love Allah, and are careful over what is lawful and unlawful. Therefore, it's the Masons that create enmity toward the Jews.
Şimdi bu iki türlü. Bir, biz Hristiyanları, Musevileri kardeşlerimiz olarak severiz, şefkat duyarız, ehli kitaptırlar.
This has two aspects. We love Christians and Jews as our brothers and we have compassion for them. They are the people of the book. We respect their beliefs. They go to their churches and the others to their synagogues and we hold them in high esteem. Even we marry their women, call them to our houses as guests, eat their food, or they come and eat our dishes. But in terms of faith, for instance, when it comes to belief in Trinity, we do not say that's good. We explain them that Trinity is wrong. We call to one Allah and tell them we do not believe in that claim. If they attempt to dominate us in that respect, then we do not assign a proponent of the Trinity doctrine as an administrator. Since we have opposing beliefs, we don't accept that. But if there is no conflict in our beliefs, then we have respect for that person. We would not deliberately assign them to such a post where they would intervene in our faith and mistreat us. Apart from that, we have high regard for them, we show them all kinds of consideration, affection and respect. There is an indication to this in the Quran, there is a verse regarding this, but people misinterpret that. They assume hatred towards Christians or Jews, but this is not correct. We are not obliged to obey them on this matter, and also in regard to matters of faith. When some people mention dialogue, if they intend to say that Christianity is a true religion and it's in force, or that a Christian has found true religion, then that is wrong. If they say Judaism is a true religion and Islam is a true religion too, and one can choose whichever he wants to, then that's wrong. This is clearly stated in the Quran. Allah says, "The religion before Allah is Islam." Surah Al-Imran 19. There is only one true religion. Christianity and Judaism were distorted, but they still maintain all features of true religions at their principal root on a wide scale. Why is anti-Semitism a kind of racism that is totally against Islam? We have love towards descendants of prophets. We feel affection for the prophet Abraham's, peace be upon him, sons.
A prophet, peace be upon him, is from the prophet Abraham's, peace be upon him, lineage, and so is Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him.
Abdülkadir Gilani, as well as all great imams, is descendant of prophet Abraham, peace be upon him.
That's why we cannot have any enmity or animosity against the lineage of the prophets.
That could only have a place in an evil mind and in evil thoughts. We are against atheist Zionism. Otherwise, we love devout Jews with great compassion.
We also feel affection and have love for them because they are the lineage of the prophets.
In that sense, we may have no opposition or animosity towards them. That would be unlawful, and it has no place in Islam. On the contrary, there is protection, shelter and kindness in the Quran, and we are obliged to act that way. They will surely practice their religion as they like, and that's the same for Christians also, and we may only have positive involvement in that respect, not a negative one. Jerusalem is one of the first places I want to go. Until now, I haven't left my country once. I have never been abroad, and that's where I wish to go for the first time I travel outside the country. Mecca, Medina, and Jerusalem are the three significant locations for me. But Jerusalem will nevertheless belong to the Muslims in the end. I am saying this as to the hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him.
Jerusalem will enjoy masses of Muslims from end to end in that entire region at the time of Mehdi's, peace be upon him, and the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, appearance. We will have Jewish and Christian brothers there with us, but Muslims will have a spiritual leadership there. They will all live in brotherhood and friendship. At the time of their awaited Messiah, that's Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him, there will be great salvation and splendor. The Prophet Solomon's, peace be upon him, palace will be built there, inshallah, in the most magnificent way. That will be next to Masjid al-Aqsa, where there is a waste area. It will be built on its original beauty and glory. The Messiah, the Prophet Jesus, peace be upon him, and Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him, will radiate light over the Islamic world from there. Therefore, Jews in Israel will live their days as they are in heaven. This and the rebuilding of the Prophet Solomon's, peace be upon him, palace are promised in the Torah. But it will be Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him, who will do that, and Mehdi, peace be upon him, will protect them. Christians and Jews are dearly loved by us. Mehdi, peace be upon him, will hug them with love and affection. He will protect and watch over them, provide them ease in their worship. They will be very much contented with Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him. This means they will be very happy and live in their golden age during the time of Hazrat Mehdi, peace be upon him, inshallah. Our beautiful Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, was very compassionate towards Christians. He would go and eat with them, eat their food. He would also trade with the Jews and encourage his companions to do so. In that era, both Christian and Jew lived their lives as they were in heaven. It was a term of peace and splendor for them. The people of the book, the people of Israel, lived in complete ease in the time of our Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace. They also lived in Jerusalem at that time, in the region of Israel. They were happy and prosperous and were treated with love and affection. One can marry Jewish girls, sit at their tables, eat food they have prepared, visit their homes and be friends with them. That was a practice in the time of our Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, and his sunnah. And it also applies to Christians. As you know, one of our Prophets, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, concubines, was a Christian. She is our mother, someone we remember with love and respect. I'm not talking about Judaism alone. Christians are also people we must regard as having a right to live in peace and happiness and plenty and abundance and the joy thereof. People of the book is entrusted to us. This has been the same in Ottoman times as well as during the time of our Prophet, peace be upon him. We see the same in the Quran, and we are obliged to protect and shelter them, to show compassion towards them and love them. We don't only conform to their beliefs, but we love them very much as human beings and our brothers and enfold them in our arms. However, if they say, Allah is beyond this, Allah is one of the three, without doubt, Allah is one. So therefore we would not agree with them. So in this aspect, we never abide by their guidance and we do not obey them. But we are surely in unity on righteous morals, and they are definitely our brothers. Our Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, used to meet with Jews, do business with them, and have relations with them. He also had relations with Christians, and that's not wrong.
Museviler değerli insanlardır. Ben Museviler çok severim. İshak, Yakup, İsmail.
The Jews are very valuable people. I love the Jews very much. Isaac, Jacob, Ishmael, Joseph and Solomon, peace be upon them all, are all our prophets, and they are descended from that lineage. Therefore, those who would seek to eliminate the Jewish lineage would seek to eliminate the lineage of the prophet Abraham, peace be upon him. It is unthinkable for a Muslim to remain silent in the face of an attempt to eliminate the lineage of a prophet. A Muslim will resist it. I myself am strongly opposed to it, and I strongly reject and oppose Jews still facing oppression, any attempt to eradicate them, and all moves aimed at ejecting them from their lands.
Hepsi Hazreti İbrahim neslindendir. Filistinliler de, İsrailliler de aynı soydan geliyorlar. Ve
Musevilik de eski bir İslam dinidir. Gerçi tahrif olmuştur ama...
They are all descendants of the Prophet Abraham, peace be upon him. Palestinians and Israelis are from the same lineage. Judaism is also an old religion of Islam, but it was distorted. In the Quran, we find the elucidation of these distorted parts of the Torah. Majority of Jews will realize this fact in time. This should be clarified and explained to them. Even if they are not convinced, their dwelling in that region is stated in the Quran, and all their ancestors, fathers and history lie there. It's acceptable for them to establish a state there and be located in that area. There is nothing wrong with that. However, it's of significance that they should not employ an aggressive policy. They live there at the time of our Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, and they may keep living there until the Day of Judgment. They should not transgress and should act in consistence with being the people of the book. Christians are also the people of the book, and they may live there freely as they like. There is no difference between Christians and Jews in terms of being the people of the book. It is clearly stated in the Quran that moderate conduct and friendly relations should be established towards them. Laws governing the people of the book are very clear, and guidance of our Prophet, may Allah bless him and grant him peace, is established. There is no need to find this peculiar. We should earnestly take care of devout Jews in Israel, just like we watch over Palestine most efficaciously. They are entirely ours. Some of them are children of Jacob, peace be upon him, and others are children of Ishmael, peace be upon him. Some of them are descendants of the Prophet Jacob, peace be upon him. Some are descendants of the Prophet Ishmael, peace be upon him. They are the lineage of the prophets. The entire nation and breed comes from the prophets, and they are very devout and pure people. There are atheist Zionists and Masons who are troubling them. There is a group that aims to break them and make them to destroy one another.
We need to pull them aside, to withdraw this evil clan, and let our devout and pure brothers of prophet lineage live in happiness there.
One-sided politics is wrong. That would not conform to justice or conscience. It would not be reasonable as well. And we cannot ignore such glory because Jews are very devout and dignified people. We must definitely protect and safeguard them, but at the same time, we must free the Palestinians from these troubles as our brothers.
Tevrat'ta şöyle bir izah vardır. Hasmına saldırmadan önce onu barışıklığa davet et der.
There is a description in the Torah that says that before attacking your enemy, you should call him to peace. So he first says, what we have done, would we ever come to such a point, I'm sorry and I have given up my behavior, please forgive me. And then he decides to attack. One should act according to this way of thinking. But there is another attribute of atheist Zionists. They are extremely cowardly. What we need to do is to take care of devout Jews much better and bring them close to us. This means we should be more passionate, more sincere, and determined to draw them on our side and reassure that we will guard and protect them very well. Because atheist Zionists have a very apparent plan. At the moment, I'm writing a detailed book about this. They plan to kill the entire Jews, leaving only 144,000 of them. See that they plan to kill them all apart from 144,000 Jews, and they are preparing for the Armageddon war. We will not let this happen, and we will not let them kill the Jews.